Hey everyone, Nate from Grower's House, and we're doing our newest test, which is the double-ended metal halide shootout. Now there are two companies in the space. We wanted to see what they had to offer and what their spectral distribution looks like, you know, so we can really compare these lamps against each other, see the pluses and minuses of both. So there's two companies in the market at the current moment. That's Maxpar, which is engineered and distributed by Nanolux, and then there's Solus Tech. And if you take a look at these two lamps, which I'll bring them up here, they actually look quite different. Solus Tech here on the right, Maxpar here on the left. These are both 1000 watt metal halide bulbs. These are both their 4K versions. So what you'll see here is that the Solus Tech doesn't have what's called an outer jacket that Nanolux has on their double-ended metal halide, which this outer jacket is something that's completely new. It's a patent-pending design by Nanolux and their engineers. And they said they made this outer jacket because they wanted to be up to NEC and ANSI standards. Essentially, metal halide bulbs, if they do go out, sometimes they do burst. And so they wanted this borosilica glass over it to make sure that you're protected in that way. And I talked to Solus Tech about that, and they said they've designed their bulb, even though it doesn't have the outer jacket, that it is safe to use. And mainly, when we're talking about safe to use, we're talking about open rated fixtures versus closed fixtures. Closed fixture is like your normal, what I would say, an air-cooled fixture that has a glass lens that keeps the bulb enclosed. Whereas something like a Gavita or a bulb or a reflector that doesn't have any glass is an open rated fixture. So, you know, we've ran these both of these bulbs in both. They're both quality bulbs, so both companies recommend you can use both of them in open or closed fixtures. They just have a different way of going about it. Now, when we test these, I would imagine that, you know, it's a little bit of a give and take. What you might gain in a little bit of safety on this one, which we'll see. We'll have to throw it under our spectrometer, but we'll see if that changes any of the spectrum or intensity. So that's what we're here to really figure out today, and we're bringing out all the bulbs in their entire lineup. Solus Tech has a 4K, a 6K, and a 10K, and the Maxpar has a 4K and a 6K. Now the 4K, I'm referring to Kelvin, so the Kelvin scale. So 4K is really, you can use it for vegetative growth, but you could also use the bulb for flowering. So it's a little bit of a one size fits all bulb, whereas the 6K is a dedicated flowering bulb. It gives you more of a blue spectrum. That's much better for a plant to have shorter internodal spacing for its leaves and different offshoots, and at the same time give you a little more foliage and growth so that your plant has more node sites for flowering. And whereas Solus Tech has one added SKU, which part in their inventory, which is the 10K, which is really made for the end of flowering. They recommend using this like the last 2 weeks of flowering because it has a high amount of UV. So that high amount of UV is going to mean that when you measure PAR, which is the intensity within the normal realm of wavelengths that plants use to photosynthesize, the UV doesn't show up there. So the 10K, if you measure it under any PAR meter, it's going to be quite a bit lower in intensity than your normal 4K, 6K, or HPS. Where it makes up for that is a little bit more intensity in the UV area. So this one, that extra UV, at the end of flowering, it stresses out the plants a little bit, but it's a good type of stress because it causes them to produce more essential oils, which is what a lot of people are going after. So without further ado, we're going to throw these under our meters and see what kind of results we get. Let's do it. Okay, so let's take a look at the spectral charts of these bulbs. First, we'll start out with the 4K. So you'll notice that both of these bulbs are giving off the same spectrum, that 4000 Kelvin. You know, that's mainly for veg, but can also be used for flower. And you'll see that they closely match each other. And if you look at the spectrums, really you just see at some points, you see the Solus Tech just eking out the Maxpar a little bit, but actually in others, you see that the green is the highest point. So, you know, I would say these are very evenly matched spectrums. And moving over to the 6K, you see, you know, the same thing, but you see the Solus Tech and the Maxpar just in different areas. Like at the highest peak there, the Maxpar is a little bit higher than the Solus Tech, but in some of the peaks to the left of it, the Solus Tech is eking it out. But you know, again, it's just, you see how much that these spectrums really are very similar. And if you go over to the UV all the way on the left, you can see that's where that the 350 and the 400 around there,
you can see the Solus Tech is eking out the Max Par Nanolux just a little bit. But really, these spectrums are so similar. And then going over to the 10K, which the Max Par from Nanolux doesn't make a 10K, so this is just the Solus Tech one. And you'll notice over at the 350-400, the UV is much higher than the 4K or the 6K, which is what we would expect since this is a finishing bulb made to have really high UV. So let's jump over to the readings we did on intensity for these bulbs. So we did intensity of not only the UV, or not only the normal light, but actually the UV. And just as those graphs showed, the intensity of the UV spectra for that 10K is up and above all the other bulbs quite a bit at 43 versus the other bulbs, which are down. You see the Solus Techs are, this 4K and 6K are about 26, and the Max Par is at 4K 23 and 6K 21. So the Solus Tech did a little bit better, it looks like, in the UV, but they're pretty close, like just maybe a 10 to 20% difference from the Max Par Nanolux. But then when you go down to the overall intensity, that's where it actually flip-flops a little bit, where you notice that the Max Par light was actually overall giving out slightly more intensity in par, which is the 400 to 700 nanometer wavelengths that plants use light most efficiently to photosynthesize. So where the Solus Tech 4K was at 1106, the Max Par is 1120, and then the Max Par 6K where it was at 1052, the Solus Tech was at 950. So a little bit of a greater difference there than in the 4K, which is really close. Closest makes no difference. And then the 10K is down at 925. And this is an important thing to notice. That 10K is down at 925 because a lot of its energy is focused on spectra that's outside of the 400 to 700 nanometers, namely some of that UV and IR, really more focusing on the UV, the sub 400 nanometers. So that's why you see the intensity of that UMOL go down there. But I mean, these are really interesting findings. I mean, choose the light that's best for your operation based on, you know, UV light and intensity. And, you know, these both of these bulbs are, you know, can be used in basically any DE fixer at this point. And other than that, this is Nate from Grower's House. If there's any other information you'd like, please send us an email. And happy growing.